Hello everybody, welcome back to page 39 of reading The Lord of the Rings, one page a day. We're, like I said, on page 39, which is part of The Fellowship of the Ring, which is the first book of three. We're going to continue where we left off during Bilbo's speech in Hobbiton at his 111th or 111th, 111th birthday. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you do, make sure to leave a like and let's dive right in. There was almost silence, and one or two of the Tooks pricked up their ears. Indeed, for three purposes. First of all, to tell you that I am immensely fond of you all, and that 111 years is too short a time to live among such excellent and admirable hobbits. Tremendous outburst of approval. I don't know half of you as well as I should like, and I like less than half of you as well as you deserve. This was unexpected and rather difficult. There was some scattered clapping, but most of them were trying to work it out and see if it came to a compliment. Secondly, to celebrate my birthday. Cheers again. I should say our birthday, for it is, of course, also the birthday of my heir and nephew, Frodo. He comes of age and into his inheritance today. Some perfunctory clapping by the elders, and some loud shouts of Frodo, Frodo, jolly old Frodo, from the juniors. The Sackville Bagginses scowled, and wondered what was meant by coming into his inheritance. Together, we score 144. Your numbers were chosen to fit this remarkable total. One gross, if I may use the expression. No cheers. This was ridiculous. Many of the guests, and especially the Sackville Bagginses, were insulted, feeling sure they had only been asked to fill up the required numbers, like goods in a package. One gross indeed, vulgar expression. It is also, if I may be allowed to refer to ancient history, the anniversary of my arrival by Beryl at Ascaroth on the Long Lake. Though the fact that it was my birthday slipped my memory on that occasion. I was only 51 then, and birthdays did not seem so important. The banquet was very splendid. However, though I had a bad cold at the time, I remember and could only say thank you very much. I now repeat it more correctly. Thank you very much for coming to my little party. Obstinate silence. They all feared that a song or some poetry was now imminent, and they were getting bored. Why couldn't he stop talking and let them drink his health? But Bilbo did not sing or recite. He paused for a moment. And we will pause for a moment as well, because page 39 has now come to an end. We will be back tomorrow with page 40 of The Lord of the Rings. In the meantime, I hope you enjoy your day, enjoy the rest of it, and I will see you tomorrow. All right, I'll see you guys. Bye-bye.